Me and HB going Juvie and BG. They gotta put my face on the box of Wheaties. I'm praying for whoever think they compete. Salute when you see me. Hey, greetings from LA, superstar. I just finished having some of the best sushi you could ever ask for, but I don't want to make you too jealous. But listen, I've been hustling like crazy out here, and I've got a lot of stuff lined up for us for when we come out here together on your bye week. You're a wanted man out here in Cali, bruh. I'll get you the details later on, though.
Don't hit too low, no, I need my legs. Coach, we sit him, young dog, can't catch. send up to the bench. I done lost what I'm speaking. I'm long for a default. This ain't come from the league. I got take care of mass. Ride to the wheels, don't crash. And I hit whoever long as we get past. Take it back to pale touchdown. Well, I thought.
Even with Tom Brady gone in 2020, the Jets still couldn't beat the Patriots. New York has dropped 10 straight to New England, but they'll try to turn the plane around next.
Take the Lincoln Tunnel through Weehawken, through Secaucus, across the Hackensack River. Life Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. A few moments ago, the crowd here was on their feet as their beloved Jets made their way out of the tunnel. They're ready to go. We're ready to go. It should be a good one as those New York Jets get set to face off with the New England Patriots. Brandon Gaughton alongside Charles Davis and CeeDee, you look at the Jets coming into play. They think they can run the football in this one, but there's a group on the other sideline that thinks otherwise.
Yeah, it's always intriguing when you pit an offense against a defense that seems like they can cancel each other out. We've got a top five rushing offense against a top five defense. So a lot of times it comes down to execution and maybe a little bit of that, what coaches call want-to.
Drop you in at the start of this next possession in a 3-0 ball game. Throwing on first down, Cobb. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down. Keelan Cole, the intended target, and that'll bring up second down. Now the first carry for Le'Veon Bell. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. He lost four there, and it's third down. This defense for the Pats, terrific last week in the season-opening victory.
And what I saw on film was a nearly unstoppable pass rush. Five sacks last week, plenty of hurries given up. So now what do you do on offense? You just max.
Trying to fit it into Miller, but it's intercepted. Devin McCourty picks it off, and he's able to get it back to right around the 27. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Now, early on, you know, Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game, but I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I would agree with that totally because all division games have a little extra to them. But I like where this game is situated because at this stage of the season, it has that little extra juice, but at the same time, it's not a make or break if this were, let's say, week 15, 16, somewhere in that neighborhood.
We spent a lot of time talking about what's going on the field. How about off the field with the evaluation? And they spent a lot of time saying, we've got to get a rookie in here who has big playability. And that's exactly what we're seeing here early in his career.
Drafted him in the spring. Here he is early in the fall making an impact. Now a first down carry by Bell. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave him seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Looking to throw on second down. Cobb. And that'll be incomplete.
These two teams, Charles, the Jets and the Patriots, great rivals in the AFCs going back to the beginning of the Super Bowl era. Been a long time. Now, of course, in the recent memory, the Patriots, they have dominated, and that's capital D dominated. But, you know, change comes eventually, and the Jets, they've got a new coach, new quarterback, and this rivalry, you feel like it could get very interesting again in a hurry.
Absolutely, because as we learned in 2020, it's no longer Tom Brady is guaranteed to win the division because he's no longer there. And we saw Buffalo take command in 2020. So this division, more open than it's been for the last 20 years or so.
And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down. Now the Jets send on Braden Mann to punt. Back deep for the Patriots, Gunnar Olszewski. Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. Yeah, he was looking for the checkup bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Well, they're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So it's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up five or six first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory.
And he will take this up to about the 8-yard line. The corner, Stephon Gilmore, on the stop.
Watch out, watch out.
10-0 the score after one on EA Sports. On second down, it's Bell. And he's only able to work this from the 8 to the 10 for a pickup of 2.
Some of these play calls, I think they're a little conservative, but you know me, because it's easy to sit up in this booth, right, and make all the calls and think I'm going to be correct. But I would like to see them open things up, because otherwise this defense is going to gang up on the run and shut them down.
And that nearly intercepted. Boy, for a guy known for his hands defensively, that's a ball he probably thinks he should have come up with. But instead, it's fourth down. The punt team on now is from their end zone. They get it away. Call it 46 yards on the punt, just a single yard on the return as he was covered quickly. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. They're down 17-0, really needing to find that offensive spark on this drive as they have it with a first and 10. They'll start the drive with a carry by Bell. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 4 coming up.
We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle. Now a 3rd down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
This offense has definitely been slow getting out of the gate. It's almost like they missed their wake-up call for this one. No points on their first two possessions, and now it's looking like none on this one either.
On 4th down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. It's a 44-yard punt, just 3 on the return, and the Patriots take over. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And in a spot like this, still more than a minute, I think if you put something on the board before halftime, that would go a long way towards helping them get back into the game.
There actually is something to the psychology.
The Pats are going to get there. Down he goes. Lawrence Guy in there to get him. It's a loss of 5. Behind the sticks here with a 2nd and 15.
So don't say nothing.
Mike Fire.
Off the play fake. Cobb airing one out for Crowder. He's got a man complete. 20. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Jamison Crowder. An 80-yard touchdown. And the Jets are on the board here in the final minute of the first half. Well, we know that he can beat you in a number of ways. He can catch it short, he can take it long, or he can do what we just saw. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And you have to think, Charles, down three scores already. They need to play an almost perfect second half to have a solid chance.
And that absolutely starts with finding some way to put together a touchdown drive here. They need to be smart, fast, efficient, get the ball into the end zone, and do it again multiple times in order to have a chance to win this game.
So, Charles, this game number two in the NFL career, this rookie quarterback, his guys took the loss in the opener. And when asked after that game by reporters how he did, he was pretty curt. He said, not well. What did you see?
Well, first and foremost, I loved his answer to the media because he was being honest. And those veterans in the locker room, they're looking at him to see how he's going to handle things. And they like the fact that he's not blaming other people, because I thought he struggled. The only thing that's going to help him, though, reps. No matter how many big games you played in college, how well you do in practice, the reps in the real games, that's when you begin to grow as a quarterback.
And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and eight coming up. Back to throw. Cobb. In trouble, and he's taken down. Lawrence Guy able to get in there and drop him for a loss.
Looks like another empty possession here, partner, and I don't think with three scores down in the third quarter, they can truly afford any more the rest of the way.
No, especially the way their offense is sputtering. I think you're exactly right. They got to find some answers quickly.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken just outside the 20-yard line. 37. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times, the punter goes to someone, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep him warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. They'll go again with Bell. And he's upended at the six as they double their room to maneuver on a pickup of three.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And now off to the races, down the right side, and all the way in, touchdown, New York. Keelan Cole, 94 yards, and the Jets are able to cut into this deficit here in the final minute of the third. Well, like so many wide receivers, he is a threat with the ball in his hands, and he's able to do his damage here after the catch.
And I caught a quick glimpse of him before the ball was snapped, and there was something about his body language.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10, again from the 25-yard line. To throw again, Cobb. And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack. Lawrence Guy able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
Remember, throughout my career here, defensive coaches always say, guys, you got to earn the right to rush the passer. Well, they put themselves in a great spot with this big lead, and they know they've got to throw the ball.
These pass rushers have to be salivating. It is pin your ears back time indeed.
And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. It's a big play there for the Jets on third down. We saw this plenty last year in college. He loved to take his shots downfield, and that throw, that was a thing to behold there.
Well, one way or the other, you knew they'd have to push the ball downfield on third and long, but I'm not sure the defense was expecting to push it that far downfield. Their math didn't add up, but it certainly did for the offense.
Yeah, and that throw traveling an even 64 yards in the air. And now hold everything here as the challenge flag is out, and we're going to get a review of that last play. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, it certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call.
After reviewing the play, ruling on the field stands.
So the decision to challenge does not pan out, and that's also going to cost him a timeout. It's complete to Cole, and he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. Looking to throw, Cobb. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. Let's go. Mike's by four. Again, he'll drop to throw. Touchdown, Jets! Jamison Crowder! With two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Jets are able to close the gap just a bit. So this back now to a 10-point spread, and you have to imagine they'll line up and go for two.
Oh, no question about it. If they can get this to an 8-point game, they can make things awfully interesting here in these last few minutes.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
Complete to Cole, and he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Working the sideline there. Good route, good catch. First down, and he gets out of bounds.
They have to like the play call because you have to run some guys down the middle of the field to draw some of the defenders away. They can't just let them guard the sideline exclusively. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and incompletions to use the clock.
Play and they're already just shy of midfield. They'll look to throw. He's got a man wide open. It's Landry. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
From the 32 now. Here's first and 10. Back to throw. Looking left side and he's got a man. That's Cole. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. First down now, but that clock rolling. He'll look to throw. That is caught inside the five. And inside the five here before he's out of bounds right at the three. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap, to stay inbounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch.
Muzzle damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've rung the bell three times with passing touchdowns, but guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
First and goal, a touchdown and a two-point conversion here are musts. They'll try and run it in with Bell. And he's into the end zone. No flags. It's a touchdown. And now a two-point conversion. And we'll be tied here in the final minute.
Do they have one big call left? Here we go. The touchdown's massive. But now they've got to have two to possibly take this to overtime.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Their defense did its job, got the stop. All they need is three, and this is over.
Couldn't have done much else other than score themselves and end it. But they turned it back over to them, and now all they need is a field goal to win the game. Excellent job by the defense. Can the offense finish things off?
And part one is done, now part two. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one. Again, it's Bell. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. This is a big early season game, especially an overtime win. That can give you a big boost going forward in the season.
It certainly can, and I don't think you're overhyping it because cliches go out the window when you start to play overtime. And you're right, the winner of this game now, that's an extra boost moving forward. And it actually is an extra hurt for the team that loses because normally you shake it off, but in this situation, it lingers a little bit longer.
And he's got the hook up to Landry. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. That catch good for five. It's third down. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
They'll try and run for it with Bell. Bell so light on his feet, and he is going to have a Jets first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Brandon, I think you and I were both raised the same way in the game of football. You run to set up the pass, but I think we've discovered in this NFL, a lot of teams pass to set up the run, and that's what they've done throughout this game. They've aired it out, thrown it around the yard. Now they've come back to the running game, and they find a way to be successful with it.
63 yards rushing for him now as he is just trying to will his guys to an overtime victory. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
First down, Bell, and he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Pretty straightforward play there by the linebacker. He saw the run, went with straight ahead pursuit, and dumped him behind the line of scrimmage.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. He's going to go up top for the end zone. And oh, that would get a wide up incomplete. Nearly an interception in the end zone. Probably should have been. Third down coming up.
After what they faced during this game where they've given up a ton of yards downfield, it has to be a measure of revenge right there for the secondary. They've been shredded throughout the game and finally forced an incompletion.
A long way to go here on third down for the eighth play of the drive. Back to throw. Cobb. Oh, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And the Patriots are going to have it with a chance to win the game here in overtime. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Neither team scored yet. Now we go to sudden death. Next points win this game.
How about the tension right now? It is ratcheted up, isn't it? I mean, now whatever happens, points are scored, that's your ball game. Can't wait to see the defense now. Do they get a little more aggressive in order to not let a team just drive the ball easily down the field?
Gotta be careful.
If you just give up something easy and cheap. But some defensive coordinators, they'd rather take a stand that way as opposed to being nickel and dime down the field.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. The give is to Bell. A good gain of 9 before he's brought down at the 28.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. Well, how about this? The very, very rare tie that we just witnessed. Hard to believe.
You don't see it very often. A bonus period of football, yet both teams go home a little bit unsatisfied.
So that's it. No double overtime until the playoffs rolled around, so that means this one ends in a tie.
Yeah, that's ultimately unsatisfying for both teams, the fan bases. Heck, for us,
true.
We came here to see a winner, right?
We
did. Winner and a loser. We didn't get it. We end up with a tie. Everyone walks away. A little bit cranky on this one.
Meh.
Yeah.
M-E-H, man.
So I'm back with my brother and together.